Shalom, shalom. This is Rabbi Moshe Otero, Ways of Israel. Post was stated, what's our view of LGBT? Obviously, the best way to answer that question in a world which is very highly charged of being correctly, politically correct, is a response of LGBT. What's that response? Let's get back to Torah values. That's my response to LGBT. Once we understand what the values of Torahs are, our response to LGBT will be clear. We don't need to argue. We don't need to fight. But we do need to respect those who happen to hold and embrace the true LGBT value. That is, let's get back to Torah value. So tired to see so many different things, so different movements that we're seeing popping up that cause strife and division in this country because the value systems are not what we necessarily embrace. And thus, there is a push to have all people from all worlds accept the same cultural values that destroyed the ancient societies of the past. I, for one, am fully in favor of embracing the LGBT Torah community. Yes, LGBT. Let's get back to Torah. That's my message. We need to get back to Torah. We need to learn Torah. We need to reestablish Torah in every facet of this society. And only then that maybe, This society will be saved from its own self-destruction. That's my opinion. And I think the more we learn Torah, the more we get to Torah value, the less we get into all this narshkeit that we're happening. What I believe is that even if we get back to bring life which matters back to the essence of our existence, we wouldn't need such organizations as BLM or LGBT. We'll be living it in person. We're having a life worth living. That means to respect all life. All life means all life. That means to respect the individual decision. You may disagree, but you need to respect their decision. You know, one thing we do learn that even when people in the past lived in a certain lifestyle that wasn't in agreement, you might say, with God's lifestyle recommendation, they didn't judge, just let it to God. And God took care of it. Direct intervention. So that's why my response to LGBT is let's get back to Torah. That's LGBT. When we do that, we get strengthened, we strengthen others, we don't worry about the nonsense of the political waves of each day. We are definitely living in a world that's constantly changing. India, if you've seen in the news, I mean, they're having to burn the bodies because of the amount of people dying from this virus. No one has asked. If you're looking at Torah value, no one has asked, who is responsible for unleashing this biological war, a weapon of war, onto the nations of the world? No one's asking that question. They're just sliding the hand on that one. They've also not answered the question as to whether or not there is still electoral integrity. Most of us don't believe there is. Most of us believe that something went wrong in 2020 election, and that's being clearly demonstrated by what's happening in Arizona, as the Arizona State is looking at the audit, and the parties that basically won are trying to cover up, stop the movement, stop the truth reality. And it's an incredible day that we're looking at, seeing everything that happened coming back to light, and proof is in the pudding that this election was stolen. But it doesn't end there, my friends. It doesn't end there. We're seeing the dastardly hand of those that were appointed in the office. Kerry, who is now in big trouble for having revealed top secret intelligence to Iranian officers. Now, you would say, Kerry? Yeah, he's a person that never loved us Jews. And by the way, did you see that video that came out of Riverside, New York, of one gentleman? I won't say that, I won't mention that perhaps he was part of the BLM, but throwing rocks into the synagogue, hate crime. My friends, we are espousing groups and organizations that has hatred. And truly, I 100% agree, we've got to stop the hatred. But it's got to stop from these groups that have been fomented by organizations that wish to see the downfall of America capitalism and prompt up a form of socialism. And we know who's behind it. Let's not kid ourselves. We know who's behind these organizations. And it has nothing to do with democracy. It has everything to do with anarchy and to create a system of communism in this country. So let's not kid ourselves. We know who's behind it. This government knows who's behind it. They know it. They've been planning for it. And they're the ones that's pushing for it. So let's not kid ourselves. Don't kid ourselves one iota. But yes, let's get back to Torah. Once we do that, things will begin to have a clear perspective. It's only when we lose sight of Torah that we get our heads completely wobbled-minded in the wrong direction. So let's do this whole country, this whole nation, a favor. And let's get back to Torah. When we do that, we're going to get back to the basic values of the family, the basic values of do what is right in this country. When we get back, and let's get back to Torah, LGBT. That should be the message that we should be pushing. Every time someone puts LGBT, you go, yep, I support LGBT 100%. And give them a smile. And then just say, let's get back to Torah. When you say that, it'll be very clear that whatever the Torah says, that's what we support. Whatever the Scripture says, that's what we support, LGBT. So next time someone asks you and pushes the question, oh, what do you think about LGBT? Oh, I'm 100% in favor of it. I'm in favor of seeing LGBT spread everywhere. As people get back to Torah, let's get back to Torah campaign. Could you imagine? Let this go viral. Oh, Rabbi Otero says, let's get back to Torah, LGBT. Yes. LGBT, let's get back to Torah. Now, let's see what Torah says. Once we see what Torah says, we know what our value becomes and should be. So, share this video. Let other people know that you support 100% LGBT. LGBT meaning, let's get back to Torah and Torah living. This is Rabbi Moshe Otero, Ways of Israel. Share this. Let's get back to Torah, my friends. And we'll see a better world in our current situation. Shalom, shalom.